गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम ई गोवर्धन, लेक्चरर इन केमिस्ट्री, जनरल सेक्शन, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक वड्डेपल्ली, डीलिंग सेमिस्टर, सेकंड सेमिस्टर, सब्जेक्ट इंजीनियरिंग केमिस्ट्री एंड एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज 2। और सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 18:204F। मेजर टॉपिक इज फ्यूल, सब टॉपिक कंपोजिशन एंड ऑल्सो यूजेस ऑफ gaseous fuels. Duration is 50 minutes. Next, I use teaching aids, PPTs, animations and also photographs, right? So on completion of this period, our objectives are advantages of gaseous fuels, means compare with other fuels, solid fuels and also liquid fuels, what are the advantages of gaseous fuels. Next, composition and uses of natural gas, producer gas, water gas. That means we should write how many gases present in natural gas, producer gas, water gases. So these are mixture of gases, that's why we should know composition of these gases and also uses of these gases, right? So let us start one by one. So recap. So I want to ask some questions. How much amount of heat is required for metallurgical operations? How can you produce it? Right, some metal preparation, right? Now industries which are depend on metallurgy, they require so much of heat. How they are getting? So they get by doing other processes, like by using fuels. Does the crude oil components fulfill the metallurgical needs? Exactly. So crude oil or other compositions that is used for the industries. So nowadays we are not depending on the completely crude oil. So we are preparing some other synthetic gases. Okay, let us see. First thing, advantages of gaseous fuels. Last class we discussed fuel definition and also types of, that means classification of fuels, primary fuels, secondary fuels, and physical state, solid and liquid and gases. So compare with other fuels like solid and liquid, gaseous fuels have somewhat advantages. That's why our topic is advantages of gaseous fuels. So see here, one by one we will discuss. They can be lighted at a moment's notice. So that means gaseous fuels have low ignition temperature, that we can easily burn that fuel compared with solid fuels and also liquid fuels. That's why the gaseous fuels can be lighted at a moment's notice. Next point, they are transported easily. Right, one place to gaseous fuels transported very easily from one place to another place. So compared with fuels and also compared with solid fuels and also liquid fuels, right? So they give high energy. So on combustion, gaseous fuels give high energy. That means compared with same, suppose if you take same amount of gas fuel and also liquid fuel, solid fuel, so the gaseous fuel give high amount of energy compared with other liquid and also solid. So that is the point. So here transportation means by using supply pipelines also we can use for the gaseous fuels. It's not suitable for the liquids. Next, they burn without any soot and also ash. Suppose if you try to burn firewood are also coal, they give byproducts like charcoal, coke and also coal also. So they give some soot also. So now gaseous fuels, they burn without any soot and also ash. Okay, if you take for combust, if combust the carbon material, it give ash also, soot also. But the gaseous fuels burn without any soot and also ash. This is also very important. They have high calorific value. Gaseous fuels have high high calorific value means. So if you take small amount of gas fuel, it give high amount of heat, that means high amount of energy. So that's called they have high calorific value. That's why we are using gaseous fuels frequently. So next, release less amount of pollutants. So solid fuels and also liquid fuels, they release poisonous gases, means poisonous pollutants or other pollutants or contaminants releasing into environment. But gaseous fuels, they release amount of pollutants, less amount of pollutants. Suppose if you take suppose one vehicle running with petrol or diesel, it's give high amount of high quantity of pollutants into environment. Suppose if you take same vehicle, if you use CNG gas or other gases, ethanol like gases, it give less amount of pollutants, that means releasing into environment. So we can say from that example, gaseous fuels release less amount of pollutants into environment. Next, combustion is easily controllable, right? Starting and also closing that combustion is very easy. That means combustion is easily controllable, we can control, right? If you use LPG gas, so by using stove, we can simply switch on or switch off. That's why combustion is easily controllable. So note down that these points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 points. Note down these advantages, 7 advantages. I give 1 or 2 minutes. These are the advantages of gaseous fuels. Okay, they can be lighted at a moment's notice. They are transported easily. They give high energy. They burn without any soot and also ash. They have high calorific value. Release less amount of pollutants. Combustion is easily controllable. I think you have already noted down. See, furtherly, other advantages. So the combustion of gaseous fuels can be controlled by very easily. Just now, last slide also we discussed this point. Okay. So the combustion of gaseous fuels can be controlled very easily. That means switching on and also off, it is very easy. Next, they burn without heat loss. So suppose if you use fuel, solid fuel or liquid fuel, some heat loss takes place. If you use gaseous fuel, there is no loss of the that means less loss of heat less loss of heat. So finally we can say they burn without heat loss. Next, they are free from solid and also liquid impurities. If you take solid materials, they have somewhat impurities. Liquids also, there is chance to liquefy with other chemicals. In gaseous fuels, they are free from solid and also liquid impurities. Next, fuel and air are uniformly mixed with each other, hence complete combustion takes place. For liquid and solid, somewhat difficulties in combustion, but gaseous fuels, the gaseous fuel and also air uniformly mixed with each other, hence complete combustion occurs. So other advantages of gas, they completely combustion takes place. While at the same time gaseous liquid fuels and also solid fuels, they did not combustion takes place 100%. So somewhat uncombustible material releasing into environment, those are very harmful to environment. At the same time, in gaseous fuels, fuel and also air informally mixed with each other, hence complete combustion takes place. These are the advantages of gaseous fuels. Note down these points. Already 7 points completed in last slide. 8th point, 9th point, 10th, 11th. So note down these points. Okay, I think you have completed. See here, combustion gases fuels can be controlled very easily. They burn without heat loss. They are free from solid and liquid impurities. Fuel and air are uniformly mixed with each other. Hence, complete combustion occurs. So these are the advantages of gaseous fuels. Right, let us discuss composition and uses of natural gas and also producer gas and water gas. First of all, we discuss composition, next uses. So see here, composition of gaseous fuels. First one, natural gas. So see average composition of the natural gas. Methane, so 70 to 90%. Ethane, 5 to 10%. See here, I try to write formula of methane and ethane. Okay, just wait, I am taking pen. So methane formula, CH4, methane CH4, ethane C2H6, C2H6, other hydrocarbons. You can see now. Right, natural gas average composition, methane formula is CH4, 70 to 90%. Ethane, C2H6, that is 5 to 10%. Other hydrocarbons, sorry, it is not hydrogen carbons, hydrocarbons. Okay, other hydrocarbons, 3%. Calorific value is 12,000 to 14,000 kilocalorie per meter cube. This is the composition of the natural gas. So this is a light GMW. Gram mole per weight, or low number of carbon compound, that is methane, only single carbon, right? So percentage 70 to 90%. Ethane, that is CH3, or you can say C2H6, percentage is 5 to 10%. Other hydrocarbons, 3%. Calorific value 12,000 to 14,000 kilocalorie per meter cube. Note down this composition. So this is a composition of gases fuel. See here. Now some types of in that fuel. Just wait. Okay, so we completed composition. Next, see here how the natural gas available in our earth crust. See here, here I have written some points. It is available in sedimentary rocks, right, which are present in the earth crust. So it is available in sedimentary rocks with the petroleum in oil wells formed by decomposition of organic matter. So with petroleum, crude petroleum also, it is available natural gas. So in oil wells, so how it is forming? By the decomposition of organic matter, so natural gas formation takes place in sedimentary rocks. It is a mixture of the hydrocarbons. So in this natural gas, we have different hydrocarbons: methane, ethane, propane, butane, like that. So it is divided into two types on basis of the components present in it. So depend on the mixture of hydrocarbons, it is classified further two types. That is dry natural gas and also wet natural gas. So what is that meaning of the dry natural gas? See here, contains lower hydrocarbons. So if it is have mixture of hydrocarbons, that means lower hydrocarbons means methane, ethane, propane, butane, etc. These are examples for the lower hydrocarbons. They are dry natural gases. Next, wet natural gas means it contains higher hydrocarbons. Means pentane, hexane, octane, nonane, decane, like that. Higher hydrocarbons present in wet natural gas. So somewhat it is wet component. So this is the further explanation of the natural gas. Note down these points. Okay, now uses. So natural gas uses. See here, natural gas used. It is a fuel for domestic and also industrial purpose. So natural gas used as a fuel for the domestic and also industrial purpose. Means it is also used as a illuminant. It is used as a raw material in the synthesis of various chemicals like ethanol, methanol, and also other chemicals preparation, acetic acid, also prepared by natural gas. So a raw material in the synthesis of various chemicals, that is another use. And it is a source of hydrogen. So by using natural gas, we can prepare hydrogen and use it in the preparation of the LPG gas. Now this natural gas also used in the preparation of the LPG gas and CNG gas, etc. And natural gas also used as a fuel in railway locomotives. So it is used as a fuel in railway locomotives. These are the uses of natural gases. See here, once again I'm repeating. It is used as a fuel for domestic and also industrial purpose. A raw material in the synthesis of various chemicals. We are using as a raw material natural gas. Next, a source of hydrogen and used in the preparation of the LPG gas. Next, a fuel in railway locomotives. So these are the uses of natural gas. Note down all points. I will give some time. So this is natural gas. See, other gas, that is producer gas. Second gas is fuel, that is producer gas. See here, preparation of the producer gas. It is prepared by passing steam and air over red hot coke or coal at 900 to 1000 degree centigrade. Suppose assume, right? So assume here I am drawing like a pipe. Assume it's a red. Now we are sending steam. Just wait. Steam plus air we are sending into, this is which pipe? Red coke. Okay, red coke. See here, now you can see this one. Here we are sending steam, we are passing steam and also air from this pipe. It is a red coke pipe. This coke have temperature, this pipe have temperature 900 to 1000 degrees centigrade. From this pipe we can pass this steam or air. Finally we are getting producer gas. See compositions of producer gas. The average composition, carbon monoxide is 33% that is carbon monoxide, into nitrogen gas is 64 to 65%. It is high amount in producer gas. Remaining gases, H2, hydrogen and also carbon dioxide, methane, means H2, CO2, CH4, etc. They have little amount. So calorific value of producer gas is 1160 to 1420 kilocalorie per meter cube. So this is average composition of the producer gas. Note down this composition. Right, this is producer gas composition. Next, see here, uses of producer gas. It is used for running gas engine and also it is used for heating open hearth and also mobile furnaces. It is used as a reducing agent in your metallurgical operations and also it is used in the manufacture of the ammonia. So these are the use of producer gas. See here, it is used for running gas engines, right? Open hearth furnaces and also muffler furnaces. Used as a reducing agent in the metallurgical operations. used in the manufacture of ammonia. So this is uses of producer gas. Note down these points. Okay, these are the uses of producer gas. Next, the final water gas. Average composition is here. Carbon monoxide 40 to 50%. Hydrogen H2 45 to 50%. Carbon dioxide 4%. Nitrogen gas 3%. Calorific value 2796 kilocalories per meter cube. So composition: carbon monoxide 40 to 50%. Hydrogen gas 45 to 50%, carbon dioxide 4%, nitrogen gas 3%, and combustion it's give calorific value 2996 kilocalorie per meter cube. This is the composition of water gas. Note down. Okay, now see how preparation takes place. Water gas is produced by passing steam over red hot coal or coke, same as producer gas preparation. So C plus H2O gas, carbon coke plus H2O gas, it's giving CO, carbon monoxide plus H2O. This is called water gas. So note down this equation just in a moment. Right, now water gas uses. See how water gas used as a fuel in industries, used in manufacture of methane and also methyl alcohol, etc. Used as a illuminant, used as a source of hydrogen. These are the uses of water gas. Right, so if you want to see how production of the water gas, you can search in YouTube also. Used as a fuel in industries. Used as in the manufacture of the methane and also methyl alcohol, etc. Used as illuminant, used as source of hydrogen. Note down these points. If you have any doubt, so search in YouTube or Google. Right, summary. Up to now we have discussed about advantages of gaseous fuels, composition and uses of natural gas, and also producer gas, water gas. Okay, so this is our topic. Let's see kids questions on our topic. First one, the main composition of the natural gas is, main composition of the natural gas is A, methane, B, CO plus H2, C, CO plus H2, sorry, same repeated, D, CO plus N2, which is the correct answer. So main composition is methane for natural gas. So for option A is correct answer for the first question. See second question. Natural gas calorific range is, natural gas calorific range, see here. So 1160 to 1420, it's not for natural gas. 3000 kilocalorie, not. So 12000 kilocalorie, it's not correct. So which is the answer? 12,000 to 14,000 kilocalorie per meter cube. It is the correct answer for the second question. So natural gas calorific range is 12,000 to 14,000 kilocalorie per meter cube. Next, to see another question. the main composition of the producer gas is main composition of the producer gas. So which is the correct answer? CO is N2 is the correct answer. CO plus N2, it is the main composition of the producer gas. So CO plus H2, it's a water gas. Okay, third question answer is CO plus N2. Next, fourth one, calorific value of producer gas is, calorific value of producer gas is in range of, producer gas is calorific value and 1160 to 1420 kilocalorie per meter cube. What is the answer? 1160 to 1420 kilocalorie per meter cube. It is the calorific value of producer gas. Next, the main composition of the water gas. The main composition of the water gas is H2 plus CO, right? Or CO plus H2, B or C, both are correct answers. So the main composition of the water gas is CO plus H2. Next, see, calorific value of water gas is, calorific value of water gas is 2796 kilocalorie per meter cube. This is the answer for the this question. Next, see, the gas obtained by the degradation of biological matter, the gas obtained by the degradation of biological matter is, which is the correct answer? Gobar gas, right? So gobar gas is the correct answer. So gobar gas is obtained by degradation of biological matter. So frequently asked questions from this topic: write the composition and uses of producer gas, write the composition and uses of natural gas, write the composition and uses of water gas. And also other question, write 4 or 5 advantages of gaseous fuels. So this is our topic. Okay, so up to now we discussed advantages of gaseous fuels. Next, composition and uses of producer gas and natural gas, water gas. So next class we are going to discuss remaining gaseous fuels uses and also composition. In that, coal gas and also ethylene gas, biogas, these are the next class we are going to discuss. Okay.